Om Sri Ganeshaya Namaha. Om Sri Sarasvatyaya Namaha. Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Om Samasta Jana Kalyane Niratam Karunamayam. Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram. Om Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kansachanura Mardanam. Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Harihi. Arjuna wanted to know the essence of sannyasa and tyaga, because they both appear to be same or similar. So now we have seen Bhagavan very exhaustively explained. Here tyaga, which is called sacrifice, abandonment. But this tyaga is actually yastu karma phalatyagi satyagi iti avidhyate. So the essence of tyaga is the renunciation of personal likes and dislikes and attachment to fruits of actions and even the results that are not only meant for oneself, and that will happen only when you perform your duties. So the emphasis is on performance of duties without likes and dislikes, and then that is called as tyaga. Not tyaga means you have to give up karma only. Now anyone who does that, that tyaga phalam nalabhetam. The rajasic, tamasic type of tyaga, the result of tyaga is shanti, ananda, manashuddhi, that they will not get. Therefore tyaga phala is shanti, shuddhi, ananda. Then what is sannyas? Sannyas is the renunciation of the sense of ego, I. Because I say renunciation of likes and dislikes. Well, who has likes and dislikes? They say, I have likes and dislikes. I perform this karma for this result. So this, when a person renounces this sense of doership, which is more subtle, then that is called sannyas. And that person is never bound. Even if you perform karmas, all kinds of karmas. Now, having said that, now Bhagavan takes up very beautiful topic, and that is called the holistic vision of life. You see, to give a very simple example, see, if I get a headache, some there is a tablet, medicine, I take it. Then there is a backache, then there is a stomachache, then on. So that, all that may be. But the real solution is that I must have good health. Isn't it? Otherwise, all the time you are treating this, that. Correct? But if I enjoy good health, then everything is taken care of. So, now people keep on asking question, how to deal with success, how to deal with failure, how to deal with disappointment, how to deal with relations, emotions and frustrations and suppressions and repression, expressions, so many. So individually, how can you go on and on and on and on? Actually, you must have total vision of life. Then only you can live your life fully. And that's what Bhagavan says, Jnanam jneyam parijnata trividha karma chodana karanam karma karteti trividha karma sangraha. And he says, the jnata and karta will be one, therefore karta, karma and jnanam, they are of three kinds and we have to know. So here jnanam I will translate as the very vision of life. What is your vision of life? See, all our actions and reactions in life depend upon our vision of life. Our vision, that determines our value system. It may appear a little digression, but I want to tell you one thing. See, there are different schools of thoughts. So many schools of thoughts are there. And why there are so many differences there? So one very basic point is, what is the means of knowledge, valid means of knowledge they accept? And therefore, if you read a philosophical book, the first chapter is generally epistemology. Epistemology, that means inquiry into the valid means of knowledge. I'll just give a little example, then it will become very clear. See, there are some philosophies, they say, we only accept direct perception as the valid means of knowledge. What I see, I believe that. That's all. This is called pratyaksha pramana. So anything that we don't see and all that, that doesn't exist, we don't believe in it. So then what happens? Their whole vision of life will be determined only by the direct perception. And therefore they say, the notion about themselves will be, I am this body, because that's only seen. There is nothing other than body. This is me, that's all. And what is the goal of life? Enjoy. Enjoy. Because there is no next life, there is nothing. Gone is, the body is gone, then everything is gone. And how to enjoy? Eat, drink and be merry. But somebody say, "What? I don't have anything to eat and drink." Then borrow money. Borrow money. But if I borrow, I will have to pay. No, when you die, nothing, nobody is going to come after you, so therefore don't worry. You see, this kind of thing, I am not joking, they say, Runam Kritva Ghritam Pivet. Take loans. Maragine Pat Kona Aane Wala Piche. When you die, nobody is going to follow you, so don't worry about it. So such kind of philosophy will be there then. Then even science will have no role, actually speaking, because science, at least you perceive, and then your intellect is there, reasoning is there, logic is there, and all that. Anuman Pramana is there, but here nothing. So what I have to say, whatever is your Shraddha, your vision of life, according to that only your value system will be there, according to that only you will respond here. So therefore the socialist people are there, communist people are there, atheists are there, agnostics are there. Agnostics? Agnostics means they have not made up their mind whether the reality exists or doesn't exist. And some people are very clear, no, it doesn't exist. Some people are very peculiar. Existentialist and nihilist and materialist, idealist, so many isms are there. All these are there because of different means of knowledge, their interpretation, their understanding, and therefore the whole vision changes. What is your vision of life? That will guide everything, every aspect of your life. Okay, so now let us see what Bhagavan says. He says there are three types of vision. In that, all things will be included. A variety of schools of philosophies, these, that, everything will be included. These three types of jnanam, he calls. Jnanam, the vision of life. Okay? Now let us see the first one. Sarva bhuteshu ye naikam. Bhavamavyayamikshate. Avibhaktam vibhakteshu. Tadjnanam viddhi sattvikam. Viddhi means you understand. Tadjnanam sattvikam iti. This knowledge, this vision is sattvik, noble, pure, uplifting, elevating. And what is that vision? In the light of which you see this. Sarva bhuteshu yena ekam bhavam avyayam ikshate. Yena, that by which, or in the light of which, ikshate, a person sees, is able to see, what? Ekam avyayam bhavam. One immutable being, presence, existence, reality. They're called bhava. Bhu bhavati, asti. That vision in the light of which a person is able to see the presence of one immutable reality. Where? Sarva bhuteshu. In all beings, all things. Bhuta means bhavanti iti bhutani. All that which has come to existence is called bhuta. We are not talking about bhut preta, huh? Sarva bhuteshu. So all that which exists, all things and beings. So that knowledge by which one sees one immutable truth present in all beings. And how they are? Vibhakteshu. For our perceptions, they all are divided, separate. One thing is separate from the other. But that avyayam bhavam is avivaktam. It is undivided. Akhanda it is. So as we look at this world with our the fleshy eyes and with all our sense organs, then we see many and varied things and beings. Countless things and beings are there, and each one is separate from the other. You see, your two fingers are not similar. Your two identical twins also not fully identical. There will be some difference. Or your two leaves of a tree also not similar. So we'll find, what we find? So much variety that is there. So if you look at each and every individual, everything is different from the other. And for that much wisdom is not required. Right? A stone is different from a tree. Tree is different from animal. Animal is different from man. And man is different from woman. And all that. That we can see very, very clearly. So, and this is a river. This is a mountain. Everything can be seen separately. But to be able to see that in all these separate, divided, looking, appearing things and being, there is one common, imperishable, undivided, and indivisible. It's not only undivided, but it cannot be divided also. Indivisible, that reality is. The ability to see that is called sattvic jnana. Oh, okay. Now we'll see the rajasic, and then we'll see tamasic, and then totally we'll understand how, what difference it creates then. Okay, then you see now the rajasic also. Shloka number Pruthaktvena tu yad jnanam. Nana bhavan prithak vidhan. Vetti sarveshu bhuteshu. Tad jnanam viddhi rajasam. Now we are just now, Sattvic was pointed out, one in many, immutable in all modifying things, undivided, indivisible in all separately appearing things, that are called Sattvic Jnana. Now, Pruthaktvena tu yad jnanam nana bhavan pruthak vidhan yad jnanam veti me, that knowledge by which a person knows and believes and accepts and thinks what? That all things as they are appearing different, they are different. Each thing is different from the other. So nana bhavan pruthak vidhan, so many things and beings are there, and they are different from each other. So that person only sees differences. He is not able to see what is the common point. And that is how generally we know, when we read different schools of thoughts, again we'll ask, what are the differences in the different schools? Is there any common point? Very few people ask, is there any common point there? Common ground. When it comes to religions also, so many religions, what? Right? Religions, culture, and countries, people, are different. Everything is different. So we ask only differences. And there are plenty. So, this vision is that each one is only different from everything, and as we see, so we see differences. That one common factor is not known, seen, perceived, and some people don't even want to know it. Then that is called Rajasam Jnanam. Okay, now let us see our wonderful Jnanam. Tamasad Jnanam. So one is a very noble, uplifting or elevating vision. Second is a mediocre one. And a third, very low kind of that vision. What is that? Yattu krusnavade kasmin. Karye saktamahaitukam. Atatvarthavadalpamcha. Tattamasamudagritam. Tattamasamudagritam. That is considered, udaratam considered as tamas. Very dull, low kind of vision. What is that? Yattu krusnavad ekasmin karya saktam. When taking the part for the whole, ekasmin karya saktam. Saktam is attached to only one product, one thing of this world. And how it is taken? Krishnavat. Krishnavat means purnavat, as though that is all that. Like we say, dollar is God. Money is required, no doubt about it. But if someone says that only therefore making money, acquiring money, that alone is the whole life, and those who are sportsmen, you know, my sport is my life. Life is a sport. But if you take only one sport as life and then you are not able to play something, then so whole your life is gone. Isn't it? So, but when a part, a small thing is considered as the whole, that is be all, end all of life, then, and attached to that, ahaitukam, And there is no logic whatsoever in that, you know, no rhyme and reason. Why you are so much attached to that? Huh? Meri nazar se dekho. Then only you will say, oh, look at it from my, through my eyesight. Then you will. But there is no reason why people are so much attached to that. They just can't get. Now, so many addictions that people are caught, very terrible kinds of addictions. They are drug and drinks and all. Is there any valid reason to get into that? But there's so much that after that, you can't without that. Karye saktam ahaitukam atatvartha alpamcha. It is finite. Alpam is very limited, small thing. Atatvartha, there is no truth, no substance in that. Though no meaning in it, no purpose in it. But attached, what to do? That's called tamasa jnana. Okay, now we have seen the three shlokas. Now come back to, we start from the beginning. When a person has got this vision of seeing what called the oneness of things and beings, or unity in diversity, or one common presence of truth in all differences, then what will be his vision? That even though he sees from perception all different things, but then, see, start from this. All are sitting here, each one is different from each other, but all are human beings or not? Yes. All are human beings. Next step, all are living beings or not? Yes. You see, now you just compare. The moment you see the difference, wala, there what you will see? The moment you ask someone, you know, what is your name? Abdul Karim, Muslim. Immediately, and mind immediately register that. So what is your name? Michael. Krishna. Subramanyam, South Indian. Our minds, you know, classification immediately just begins, based on religion, culture, state, this, that, immediately, oh, you're from here. And then, again, because of that, we have got all our preferences, affinities, attachments, likes, dislikes, prejudices, because the moment you see the difference, but you say, ki all are, after all are human beings only, isn't it? Yes. So somewhere tragedy happens and I say, I will be sending money only to these people belonging to this religion or that. Then what happens? But the one who has got the vision of oneness, he will not think in that way. The very thinking will be different. Because sarva bhuteshu enekam bhavam avyam ikshate. So that person is able to see that oneness, and therefore, do you know, wherever is that vision of oneness is there, then there is love for that being is there. And where love is there, there is seva bhav also comes there. Then you are ready to do anything. See, the implication of that sattvic jnanam is that when that person is able to see that, then you say, I am one with all. Because the same truth is in me. That is called Madatma Sarvabhutatma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. So that my own self is the self of all beings. That one thing when you are able to see, then you will think of the welfare of all. Then there is a love for all, concern for all, and readiness to serve. irrespective of caste, color, creed, religion, and all those things will not be there then. And then that person's effort also will be to bring integration, not division. So this vision is unifying. So even the family also, if there are some differences are there, that person will try to see that the differences are resolved and all remain one, because united we stand and divided we fall. And so therefore that person's effort will be, wherever that situation is there, to see how that integration is brought about and not create more and more divisions. They are already there. Why are you creating more divisions then? See, for practical purposes, like, you know, one nation is divided into so many states, let us say, why? Because of the practical purpose of governance. But afterwards, you know, what happens? That it does not remain objective. They become very, very subjective only. Then the problems also arise. Now, only you have the men and women. Oh, how much the problem. Men think that they are superior to women. They think. There's a very famous saying that one man was saying that in the head of the family, I am the head of the family, I am the head. The wife said, I am the neck. The head can't move without neck. You please understand, here, there, where, it is only neck only you move. So, okay, you be the head. I don't mind. But how many problems, isn't it? Because the feelings are so strong. But what men, what women, what all the... See, the implication is far-reaching. Where is the vision of oneness, there will be love for others. And the love will manifest in the form of service, seva and all that. That will be what I call the implication of sattvic jnanam. Sarva bhuteshu yenaikam. That's called advaitam. Advaitam. But Shankaracharya ji expounded, propounded, propagated, promoted, and all that advaita bhava only. Sarva bhuteshu yenaikam bhava mavyamakshate. Now, where only differences are seen, then what will happen? Differences, the moment only you see differences, then there will be likes, dislikes, preferences, prejudices. Then who belong to my group, then they belong to my group. I, my, you, yours, immediately that division will be there. Now you see, in Ramayana you saw that all were in Ayodhya, all family living one. But that Manthara was able to put some thought in Kaikeyi's mind of this Rajasic type. No, Shiva, otherwise for her, she thought Ram, Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna, all are my children only. Then suddenly, no, Ram, Kausalya, Bharat, my son. If Ram becomes the king, then Kausalya will become Rajmata. Division created, see? But the greatness of Rama and Bharat, they didn't allow that division to play. It's full game. They said nothing doing. Because they had sattvic vision. Mahabharata also, all the cousins, they separate, he separate, and then created, became a big war. Oh, our India, when under foreign rule, British rule, all were Hindu, Muslim, everyone together only they were struggling to get freedom. Oh, the time of struggle, suddenly we are separate, you are separate, and that even now haunting. And why should we talk about them, that in our families, where all families are very, very so. Our Chinmay mission very pledge of the first line say, we stand as one family bound to each other with love and respect. I say that's why it is the most ideal thing. But we have to ask this question. Each one should ask, do we stand? Okay, make it an interrogative question. Do we really stand as one family? And I'm not talking the mission, huh? At home also. Everywhere. Do we stand as one family? Then you convert it. Do I? do I really consider as in our family only I'm talking about. I'm not talking about organization, nation and all that. Huh? Then suddenly we'll find there's not all families, huh? I'm not talking, but many places what happens, we are not standing as one family, we are only standing as putting up with each other, that's all. And each one is trying to looking for an opportunity to just get out. Then that is no good. Because this is Rajasam Dhyanam, you see the play of Sattva, Rajas, it will be seen everywhere. You see, we don't understand how things are happening. Brother, brother, partner, partner, and all the business partner, they suddenly something happens. How the divisions appear? That division is the result of Rajas Jnanam. It is playing big havoc. That unifying vision is not there. That is the thing. Then, so the result will be this kind of raga, dvesha, partiality, prejudices, I, my, you, yours, and that will be the creating division. Now, tamas, tamas, when you take part for the whole, and as that gives rise to fanaticism. Foolish attachment, fanatically attachment, and that alone is just true. Everything else is wrong. Then it can be a religious fanaticism, political fanaticism, economic, social, wherever you go, at an individual level. Only just one thing, how can that alone be the final thing? How can that be the only thing? That can be, how can that be the whole thing? But nothing. So then, this kind of attachment happens. And then what happens if I put all my heart and soul in only very small thing? And if that goes with my whole life is gone. That's a person commits suicide. Is that suicide is the result of that? Because the person puts something only in one small thing, and that person sees that this is not possible, or mar jana hi achha hai. And the dangerous thing is sometimes he doesn't die. Then there's a problem. But why it happens is suicide, why? Why the person becomes so hopeless, frustrated, and why? It's because of tamas jnanam. I thought I will never pass in my that exam, so even before appearing for exam also deny, or I will not get that job, or I will not be able to marry whom I want to marry. Mar gaya. Are? So this is what it is. Whether a suicide or person commits or kill somebody, that also is a tamas only then. For only just selfish reason, for something that their hired killers are there. Just for money they can kill anybody. Kisko marna hai? You just tell me. And I will kill. Why, ye kaun se baat hai? So the fanaticism and this kind of all tendencies, they all are the results of all tamas jnanam. How to call it jnanam also? This very kind of very faulty vision of life, and there all this is happening. The religious fanaticism creates problem, and then people say religions are dividing. Religions are not dividing, but this religious fanaticism divides. Or any kind of fanaticism, when that which is there, it will divide only, destroy. On one wall it was written, support peace or else I will kill you. He is a very good peace messenger and all that, that is very good. Huh? But he loves peace very much, but in this way. So when we start thinking very seriously about it, so then what we'll find, that these sattvic visions, implications will be like this. Rajasic, jnanas, implications, and we are seeing everywhere. Everywhere we are seeing it. At all level, our individual level, family level, social level, national level, international level, all this are we not seeing. And the Santa Mahatmas, you know what, they try to integrate. Their vision is sattvic, so therefore they try to say, why are you fighting and all that? There is only one. Sab maharama rahya prabhu eke. Ek one paramatma is there. Tujhme ram, mujhme ram, sabme ram, samaya. Sabse kar lo pyar, jagat mein koi nahi paraya. Singing is a Rama in you, Rama in me, and Rama everywhere in everyone, and love everyone. Nobody is an alien person. And the moment bhajan is over. So many things happen. Because many times what we sing, we don't even know the meanings also. And there is no such feeling also. But these visions are playing, whether we know or not, because of this, these are the results. Wherever we are seeing that, result of that only. Sattvic vision, rajasic vision, tamasic vision. And therefore, the one who has got sattvic vision, his value system also will be different. His value will be what? Live and let live, give and forgive. Such kind of that vision will be there. And tamas will be there, kill or get killed. What? Live and let live. Cutthroat, this is a cutthroat competition, that's all. Maro. So whichever way that I can just get it, my work done, I'll do that. So the whole thing is different then. This love all and serve all, just faltu vate mat karo. Don't talk of all this love all and serve all and all that. It doesn't work in this world. Don't take out this sentence without any reference context and then say, Swamiji was saying that. I am saying that the person of Rajasic, Tamas, that they will say like this. All that, don't talk, hey, here the money. प्यार व्यार सब ठीक है इंटरेस्टिंग थॉट वन गर्ल वेंट टू फादर एंड सेड फादर आई एम इन लव विथ सम पर्सन एंड ही ऑल्सो लव्स मी वेरी मच एंड आई वॉन्ट टू मैरी father asked, does he have money? She said, all men are same. He's asking same thing about you. क्या प्यार व्यार सब ठीक है मनी है कि नहीं देख तू पहले मनी इज देयर और नॉट हाँ मनी ऑल दिस आर इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स सबसे बड़ा रुपया ऐसा बोलते हाँ तो यत्तु कृष्णवद एकस्मिन् कार्ये सक्तम अहेतुकम अतत्वार्थवद अल्पम च tat tamasam udarutam. That is called tamasyan. So now, I just indicated, you go on thinking about, and everywhere, whatever you see, then you will find this is because of sattvic dhyana. Why this man thinks in this way? Because the vision is sattvic. Why this person thinks like that? Vision is rajasic. Why this? Tamasic. And then slowly we should become aware how I look at it. All things and beings, all happenings, on all that, with how I am looking at it. Please see that. Atatva arthavadalpamcha. Now, we have seen three types of, what three types of vision. Now, they will influence our karma. Okay, so now what we will find here, Bhagavan is telling three types of karma. Actually, a person of sattvic vision will do sattvic karma. Means his karma will be called as sattvic only. But what will be the speciality of that visheshta, that we must understand. So here, the aim is not only just to give, this is sattvic, rajasic, this is tamasic, but it is meant for our introspection. That where we stand, and then also we have to see that we have to correct it. If our thinking is like that, I must correct it, and then have sattvic vision in life. Now about the karma also. 23 shloka number. Niyatam sangarahitam. Araga-dvesha-takritam, aphala-prepsuna-karma, yat-tat-sattvika-mucchate. Now, niyatam karma. What is sattvic karma? Niyatam. Niyatam which is enjoined on you, which is your considered obligatory duties, obligations, and this is called bounden duty, it is called. So first of all, what I am doing, is this my kartavya or not? Kartavya karma, niyatam. Sangarahitam, we'll see all the translation first. Sangarahitam, without attachment. Aragadveshatakritam, and done without any personal likes and dislikes. Aragadveshatakritam. Aphalaprepsuna, and the karma done by a person who is aphalaprepsuna, is not hankering, craving after that result of that action. Then that karma is sattvic karma. Oh, first is niyatam. Niyatam means what? Prescribed duties. Yeah, that's called niyatam karma. Ordained duty, enjoined duty, prescribed duties. Now the question comes, niyatam by whom? Who by whom? Now you see, a child is born in a family. Right? So the family, the parents are the first one who will tell him, do this, do that. So therefore, first thing is, niyatam by parents only. Oh. At least up to the age of 5, 7, 8. Huh? So one is our parents, or there are some family traditions, are there or not? So family traditions are there. So according to that, whatever he said that you should do, then that is niyatam karma. Acha. There afterwards, the boy grows or the girl grows and they go to the school. Then the moment you go to school, niyatam. The schools also, rules and regulations are there, and do's and don'ts are there. So the school authority will tell you that this is what you have to do. School, college, university, wherever you just go. Niyatam will be there, right? Then you take a job. Take a job means you get a job. If you are lucky and all that, so you get a job. So the job also, there all job specifications are there, niyatam. You are appointed to this post and your duties are this and responsibilities are this and authorities are none. These are our authorities. Whatever is that, everything that which is given to you. So then your pay will be this, your insurance, this and that and that and that. So actual paycheck, this you will take and all. Okay. So there also niyatam or not. Then in the office it is all. And I say once you take up that job, then you have to do it. Then you can't say that I will not do, because you have already signed it. Suppose you join a social organization, voluntary organization. So there also when you join, they also have got rules and regulations. Then you also follow that. Clear. Then whichever religion you belong to, in that religion also there are religious duties and all certain also things are also said. Which is the shastras are there, and the shastra says that you must do this, that also there. So religious duties are also there. You live in the society, the social obligations are also there. Yes. So duty is a peculiar thing. You don't have to go in search of that. They're already there. Because wherever you go, already a rule is there. And therefore many places, before the yajna lecture begins also, first house rules. So they already tell you that these are the house rules. This is what you have to do, this. Everything is there. So niyatam, everywhere niyatam. So there is authority, and authority has said this is what you have. And sometime, those spiritual seekers, they themselves also decide, now I am going to do this, isn't it? And once if you decide, kya morning I will get up, I will do this meditation, then you should do it. Because nobody has imposed on you, but you have also only prescribed for yourself, then that also becomes duty then. Oh, and I must do only niyatam karma. But generally whatever we are told to do, we don't like to do that. We like to do something opposite, or someone else's things we always like to do that. Our own work will not do. And some people have to poke their nose in everybody else's affair and all that and all that. I would say, mind your own business strictly. So first is sattvic karma, niyatam. Then sangarahitam. And there is no attachment. No attachment to what? You see, attachment, there are certain times, attachment to karma and attachment to karma phala also is there. Some people know they are attached to doing certain things, they get so much attached to that karma, they are not ready to leave. Now they cannot do it, they cannot, but I will only. One actor was there, he used to play the role of Krishna. Krishna in a drama. I will only play that. Then he became old, his stomach is coming out, and this a little fat, and this and that, but I will only play. Aha. But now you should know that you have passed that where Kishore Murati, where is Kishore Murati, where is Sthula Murati? You get at it, only I will do, I don't want to allow anyone else to do that. Attachment to karma or attachment to the result, I want that result, this result, this. Why? When you are doing, when that is over, just say bye. Khatam. But as long as you are in that post and position and that you have to do it, you must do it. But no such thing that I will only do it and I will never allow anyone else. No such thing. And a phala prepsuna, and there is no such craving for the result of that. Now, result of karmas, you know, certain results what call as gross results. In the beginning, we are attached to gross. What will I get? Material gain. If I do this, what will be my material gain? After some time, we may not be hankering after material thing, but at least people's appreciation, recognition, you know, settles. मैं कुछ नहीं चाहता था दो प्यार के शब्द चाहता था चेपन only two words of some love and affection but they cannot well, bus what happened one man was an elderly person sitting and one young lady entered there was no other seat so he got up he sat down so she sat down I sat down and got busy with her some purse opening this. This man bent down and asked, did you say something? She said, no. No. Stood there. After some time, did you say something? She said, no. No, I didn't say anything. Again he bent down. Did you say something? She said, no, no, I thought you said thank you. He wanted to hear that thank you from her for that and poor man. And she was completely engrossed in her own. Now, it is true that she should say, but why are you so much about that, that somebody has to say thanks. नहीं बोला तो नहीं बोला समझ नॉट सेड एंड नॉट सेड यू डिड योर जॉब दैट्स ऑल व्हाट इज द थिंग व्हाट यू दे नो रिकॉग्निशन दे नो एप्रिसिएशन व्हाटसो एवर आई क्विट दे से ओके See, they feel, don't feel anything if I say, go quit, then they say, okay. See, this desire for fruit can be grosser, can be subtler, can be very, very subtle, and all that also, you know. Shankaracharya Bhagavan has said in the commentary on Karmanyavadi Karaste, that in performing only karma your right is there, no even desire for it. He said moksham api. There is no desire for moksha also. What moksha? What liberation? I have to do my job, my duty. So much aphala prepsuna. Then somebody says, why you say? Well, this is my duty, kartavyam. May the Lord be pleased with this, that's all. And araga dveshata kritam, no personal likes and dislikes. This we have seen earlier also, no pleasant, unpleasant duty or anything like that. Duty is duty. What, at a given time, whatever I have to do, I just do it. So then that karma is called sattvic karma. The sattvic karma, and then now again look at it with the sattvic vision. So, when a person will perform this karma, that karma will not create division. Isn't it? And the interesting thing is, duty is generally only towards someone. Children have duty towards parents, disciple has towards guru, the person has family towards the society. So it is only you are putting the other person only in the front. And for that you are doing it. So therefore your personal thing has gone, araga, dvesha, that is called sattvic vision. In the light of sattvic vision, that is one truth is present there everywhere, and my ultimate goal is to realize that truth only. So therefore it is with that aim only you do it, then that is called sattvikam karma. Niyatam sangarahitam aragadveshatakritam aphalaprepsuna karma yattat sattvikam uchyate nao rajasik. Our Gurudev has so kindly, you know, has made the chart also and then given everything for our easy understanding, you know. Like the mother, you know, feeds the child, you know, making everything, all food, and then put in the mouth like that. Like that. Yattu kame psuna karma. Sahankarena vapunaha kriyate bahulayasam tad rajasamudagritam. Tad rajasamudagritam, that karma is considered rajas karma. How is that? Yat kamevsuna karma. Kamevsu means desirous of the particular material gain and result, kamevsu is called. In other words, desire prompted. And that also selfish, what will I gain? See, in kartavya karma is what can I do for others? But here it is, what can I, it is called kamya karma. Not neither karma, kamya karma. Desire prompted. What will I get? And in that, you know, in that what will I get, it's all right. But in that also, if you follow whatever the laws, regulation, everything, then one thing. But this, the desire sometimes becomes so overwhelming, then you say, what rules, regulation and all that? I want to fulfill my desire, that also can is possible then. Desires will make person compromise. All the time he will not do only the right thing alone to fulfill his desire. But anyway, kamev suna karma, sahankarena, ahankarena sah. I am, and I want it for me. Kriyate, and another thing is, bahula ayasam. Bahula ayasam, big pomp and show and nowadays, you know, children's birthday parties. And the child is 1 year old. The child doesn't know also anything. Even in India and all that, child's birthday party they're having in Bangkok, Singapore, and they live in Bombay, the Mumbai. What is wrong with Mumbai? No, no, Bangkok. Singapore, jayenge. And they have got theme parties for children. Baba re baba. I don't know much, but here and there I go, so they tell. Then the wedding party, anniversary. And another thing, new thing has come, surprise party. And the bahula ayasam, just to give that person a surprise, what a big organization, network they have to do. One becomes in charge, calling everybody to know when. Surprise! And And sometimes the real surprise comes to that person because nobody organized any surprise party. Poor person was all the time hoping. Yes, koi to bahulaya sabhu, what is that? Today is my birthday, so what? Oh, what do you mean by that? I am born, so? Hare Krishna, Hare Rama. Is it Rajasam? Is it all okay, Rajasam? There is no need of all this. Huh? Cake bhi lange, itna huge problem. Huh? Anyway, मैं क्यों किसी को criticize करूँ? Only it is an example how they create a bahulaya sama. So in the rajoguna, the tendency will be there. Even simple thing, but they'll go on stretching and elaborating and a big pomp show this, that, and why? Then that is called rajasam. Rajasam karma. Rajas karma. And then just to show that, because the vision of differences are there, so I have to show that I have certain things which you also have, and I have certain things which you don't have. Therefore, I must have that something more than that, you know. All these are, because divisions are there, you know. And when you create more division, and then competition, and then going on. Now let us see the tamasa karma. Anubandham kshayam himsam. Anapeksha cha, or anaveksha, or anapeksha. Anaveksha cha paurusham. Mohad arabhyate karma. Yat tattamasa muchyate. Yat karma mohad arabhyate. The person does that karma under the influence of moha, delusion, illusion, infatuation, ignorance, wrong notions. It's called all moha. And then when that person does anaviksha, without seeing, without considering all these things, gir pada, dor pada. What is that? Anubandham. Anubandham means, if I do this karma, what will be its consequence? Somebody said, have you thought about the consequence? Are dekha jayega. We'll see later on. Jab hoga to, something happens, we'll see it. But you should think before. Think before you act. You people, you know, very cowardly people, you know, all the time so cautious. Over-cautious people you are. Just jump! Or what will be? Anubandham dekhai nahi. Kshayam. Kshayam is loss. You want to get something, but how much time will be lost? Energy will be lost. Your money will be lost. Thought will be lost. Sometimes even the relations will be lost. That have you thought about the loss that you are thinking of that one gain, but in that one gain, how many other losses are there? Have you considered that? What loss will be there? I told you, no? Dekha jayega. He'll see it. Why you are so bothered about that? There may be loss. I will gain that. But is it worth so much of time, energy, effort, and everything you put in? And what will be the gain? Have you thought? Nothing thought. So, anubandham, anaveksha. Not considered what will be the consequence of it, what will be the loss. Himsam. Himsam is injury, harm. How much harm you will be causing to someone just to just fulfill your only desire and all that. It is their problem. In this world only might is right. So himsa, the harm that will be caused, so many physical level it may be, emotional level it may be, himsa. Another thing, paurusham, have you considered your own strength? Whether you can do it or not. Bhid gaya wrestler se. Picked up a fight with the wrestler. And there was one boy, you know, always picking up some fight and always coming with the blues and bruises and all that, you know. And one day he came home and then he had black eye. Again, asked fight. The mother asked, who gave you that black eye? He said, nobody gives anything free. You have to fight for it. Fight for... Fight, and then this is that, and picking up fights. Paurusham, dekhai nahi, apni khud ki taakat to dekhi nahi. Now you have not seen your own strength, ability and all. That reminds me of that one very interesting example from even Ramayana, you know. Sugriva and saw Ravana there on the terrace. It is said there in Valmiki Ramayana stories, they are not in Tulsi Ramayana, they are not given. Rama and whole army is there, and one day Sugriva saw Ravana and he got so angry and furious that this Ravana took away Sita, he kidnapped him. He jumped there on him. And Ravana and Sugriva, the strength was so different, you know. Individual. Huh? And first, Ravana was little confused what happened. Suddenly one monkey jumped and all that on. But then when he found that other, he gave so Sugriva was perplexed, anxious. But somehow, you know, he entered into his armpit and beat him there and then ran away immediately. And somehow jumped and came back. And there Bhagavan Rama chided him, you know. He so scolded him, but very softly, but very firmly. He says, Sugriv, without exactly this, anubandham, kshayam, himsam, anapeha, paurusham, you never considered. What will be the consequence? Can you really fight with that Ravana? Then why we collected all army and we have come here and all that? If you individually can go and do that. I understand it is because of your love for me and all that, but it is more avivek. We have to plan everything properly first. As Guruji says, plan out your work. Then work out your plans. But planning is first. The thoughtless action is a tamoguna lakshana only. So, Bhagavan said, sattvic, rajasic, tamasic, jnanam. Then sattvic, rajasic, tamasa, karma. Okay, so now when we also do take up any work, we must see, you know, what will be its consequence and compared to gain, how much loss will be there. If loss is more and more and more, what is the point in that? It will cause so much harm to so many. And whether I can do it or not, you first see that you can do it or not. Mohat should not be. Now, having said that, so jnanam we have seen, karma we have seen. Now, karta. Karta, the doer, the worker, karta. This is another very important, beautiful topic. Karta sattvika uchyate. First is sattvika karta. And actually, those who are working particularly in voluntary organization, particularly, they must read this shloka more carefully. Well, our Gurudev also has given a true worker. He is long time back, and a true worker that had come in Tapon Prasad also. Afterwards, we are seeing who is a true worker. The true worker, sattvic karta, not only voluntary organization, especially I said, but in life itself, throughout it, because you cannot make division like that. So, who is a noble worker? Sattvic karta. Mukta sango naham vadi. Drutyutsah samanvitah. Siddhya siddhyor nirvikaraha. Karta sattvika uchyate. Karta sattvika uchyate. A person of these qualities is called a sattvika karta, noble worker. Who is that? A true worker, true sevak. You call sevak, you call worker. Who is that? Mukta sangaha. Mukta sangaha, free from attachments. Attachment to, already said, material things, or even appreciation, recognition, all those things, that it means nothing. No attachment to anything. Mukta sangaha. Anahamvadi. Anahamvadi is a, not every sentence begin with I. You saw that? I. Did you ask who did it? I. But you say anahamvadi means no such kind of I only did. No. Mukta sangaha. Anahamvadi. Druti utsaha samanvitaha. Samanvita means endowed with the qualities of druti, fortitude, and utsaha, enthusiasm. Druti utsaha samanvita. Siddhya siddhyoho nirvikaraha. Unperturbed. In other words, equanimous. In siddhi, asiddhi, success or failure, something happened, not happened, the same. Such a person is called sattvikarta. Mukta sango naham vadi, drutyutsaha samanvitaha, siddhya siddhyor nirvikaraha, karta sattvika uchyate. Now, you see, we'll take some examples, you know. And I think Ramayana is the best place to take example. Whether it's Bhagavan Rama or Hanumanji, you know, if example of sattvic karta, Hanumanji, mukta sangha, he has no attachment to anything. Huh? Ram naam only, bas Ram naam. That's why we'll find when everybody was given some reward, even Ram, Lakshman, Sita, that they didn't know what to give to this Hanumanji. Yeah, Ram used to say, I don't know what to give. And he hugged him. Aha. He no attachment to anything, wanting nothing. Anahamvadi. How did you cross that ocean? And how did you kill those rakshasas? And how did you burn that lanka? You say, Bhagavan, Prabhu mudrika lini mukamahi jaladhi langigaya charajanahi. It is only your mudrika with your name that was in my mouth. And on the strength of that ring and with engraved with that name, I just crossed. It was you did everything. Sakha mruga kaya adhikahi. I am only a monkey, only jump from one tree to another, what he can do. But only it is because of your man. So going, while coming, Sita ji gave her chudamani. And so I came. No way saying I said. But Jambavanji was there. And he told Ram, Bhagavan, all that work done by him only. We all went there together. But job was done by only him. But he himself what? No, all credit goes only to Ram. And then, if you look at Rama, after winning the battle of Ravana, he came back. And do you know, with him came this Nala, Neela, Angada, Jambavana, Hanuman, Sugriva, everybody came with Bhagavan. And Bhagavan was introducing them to a sister Rishi. And he said, Guruji, it is because of these people I got the victory, I could gain the victory. And to them he said, it is because of the blessings of Vasishtha Rishi we got that victory. So now, giving all credit to the hard work done by this Vanaras and blessings of Vasishtha Rishi, nothing to himself. Dharka anahamvadi, mukta sangaha, anahamvadi, and druti utsaha samanvitaha. To search for Sitaji, great patience was required and all that, and utsaha, and Hanumanji utsaha, what to talk of Hanuma, enthusiasm. Fast action with enthusiasm. Lakshmana was hit by that missile. And they said, you have to get that medicine, life-saving drug. Overnight, you have to come. Who can do that? Hanuman said, I will do. So from south, all the way, he'll go to that parvat and bring that. But how fast you can go and come back? You know, one Raman, he said, if there's a boiling oil, in that you put some mustard seeds, how long it will take for them to crackle. You know, those who know the kitchen, you know, they when they are hot oil, and if you put the jeera or mustard, say, I also know some peculiar, they put the pot, they put the oil, cold, and in that only they put the rye and they go wait, keep on waiting for that oil and when it is going to crackle. You should put it when it is hot. So he says, in hot oil, how much time it will take for, in that time I will go and come back. See? What? Dhruti is 48. I will not take more about Dhruti because Bhagavan is going to speak that Dhruti also with three kinds. Dhruti means fortitude. Patience. Me. All that we'll see again. Motivation is required, isn't it? Many, sometimes I go and the people say, they give me the topic, sit, tell us how to motivate our workers. I said, all the time I think how to remain motivated. I had to know how to remain motivated. And keep on your utsaha, avare baba. That enthusiasm has to be there all the time. So he says, mukta sangha, anahamvadi, dhruti utsaha samanvitaha, siddhya siddhyor nirvikaraha, unperturbed, undisturbed, Same, you know. Okay, sometimes there is success, sometimes it is not there. All that. Sometimes you get success more than expected also. Sometimes this time it has not happened, next time it will happen. What is that? That one who is able to maintain that equipoise, that is called sattvic karta. So, I think this is more than enough. We have understood the examples and all that. When you think about that, it is so wonderful. Either Hanumanji giving all credit to Rama, but Rama giving credit to his guru. In our Gurudev's life also, I have seen that. When I was seen, everything passed on to his guru only. So that's what it is called. Mukta Sangaha, Anamvadi, Dhruti Utsaha, Samanvitaha, Siddhya Siddhyo, Nirvikartaha, Karta Sattviko Uchate. So now there is a Rajas Karta, Tamas Karta. We'll see of them. And then three types of Dhruti, three types of Buddhi. So I told you Bhagavan in the mode of three now. So three things. But they are so wonderful. They bring our vision, make your vision very clear. Okay, now let us sing the name of the Lord. Let us sing. I don't know what we'll sing today. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. You are not singing loudly. It's very difficult, is it? Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. Siyavara Ramachandra ki Radhavara Krishnachandra ki Isad Guru Nath Maharaj ki Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.